वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज एल के त्रिपाठी फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल। डियर चिल्ड्रन, एज वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द मार्जिनलाइजेशन इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, प्रीवियस एक्सप्लेनेशन, सो मैनी थिंग्स वी हैव सीन इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो। दिस इज द न्यू वीडियो फॉर यू रिलेटेड टू द सेम टॉपिक, दैट इज द मार्जिनलाइज ग्रुप। हु आर मार्जिनलाइज ग्रुप? It will be known by us through this video. So let's get started. The scheduled caste, that is also known SC, is the legal and constitutional name given to the lowest ranks of society, including the Dalits, who have been given certain special privileges. This is their constitutional name, that is Dalit, mentioned in the constitution. They are also known SC, means scheduled caste, and they have got some certain special privileges by the constitution of India. The SC are divided into many castes and subcastes. They have benefited by the policy of reservation, whereby seats have been reserved for them in government-run institutions. Since very early of the time, the scheduled caste, or you can say the bottom class of the society, did not enjoy their position, their status in the common society. That's why when India became independent and constitution was framed, the privileges or special provisions have been mentioned for them in the constitution. It was thought by the politicians or constitution framers that by giving them special rights, special rebate in the field of society, economy, employment, social status, they should be provided. That's why they could also become an essential part of the society and they enjoy their status at high level. So a provision was made by the government that is known the reservation. By giving them reservation, they are given special treatment, special facilities as compared to the other people of the sections of the society. The SC are divided into many castes and subcastes. They have divided into different numbers into subcastes and castes. They have benefited by the policy of reservation, whereby seats have been reserved for them in government-run institutions. This way, the government aims to make them educated and self-sufficient so that they can come out of the shackles of the caste system and lead a respectable life. The scheduled tribes or the adivasis. Who are scheduled tribes or adivasis? Go to know. Tribals or the adivasis are believed to be the original inhabitants of the country. Officially, they are called the scheduled tribes. It is believed that the adivasis were the original inhabitant of the country. They are known as scheduled tribes. And this is believed on the basis of some historians. Some evidence is there in the history, but there is confusion in this matter by the other historians. Some believe that Aryans are the original inhabitant of this country, and some historians claim that the Adivasis are the original inhabitant of the country. Officially, they are called the Scheduled Tribes or SCTs. Adivasis are not a homogeneous group with more than 200 tribes speaking over 100 languages, which vary greatly in ethnicity and culture. They have lived mainly in forests, and many of them have lived for centuries maintaining their primitive lifestyle. Primitive lifestyle means their ancient lifestyle, pre-lifestyles. Still, many of the Adivasis or STs live in forests, hilly areas, deserts, and in remote areas. And they enjoy their own culture, own language. They have their great ethnicity and culture. More than 200 tribes speaking over 100 languages. This is there in all over India. They have lived mainly in forests, and many of them have lived for centuries maintaining their primitive lifestyle without any interaction with modern civilization. Adivasis live in different parts of the country. Their greatest concentration is in central India, notably Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Odisha, the western ghats of Gujarat and Maharashtra, and northern Andhra Pradesh. There are smaller groups in the mountain areas of Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, and also in the Andaman and Nicobar Island. Adivasis also constitute a major part of the population of the northeastern states, that is Assam, Manipur, Nagaland, Mizoram, Tripura, Meghalaya and Arunachal Pradesh. The Adivasis have always prefer to remain outside the boundaries of the traditional society. They have their own social customs, and most of them have self-sufficient economic structures as well. During the British rule, the rulers wanted to exploit the natural resources of the areas inhabited by the Adivasis, so they interfere in the tribal socio-economic setup. The Forest Regulation Act of 1865 empowered the British government to declare any land covered with trees or brushwood as government property. The Indian Forest Act, passed in 1878, imposed restrictions upon the Adivasis, Adivasi rights over forest land and produce in these protected and reserved forests. The Act turned the traditional common property of the Adivasi communities into state property. Moreover, the British forced the tribals to pay taxes. Many of them had to take loans to pay these taxes. The tribal lands were occupied by moneylenders, jamidars, and traders for non-repayment of loans. The opening of mines and factories in the heart of tribal lands and the clearing of forests due to introduction of railways led to a large-scale displacement of the tribal population. Many tribal leaders decided to protest against these discriminatory policies. As a result, the British had to face many significant tribal rebellions, such as the Santhal rebellion and the Kol rebellions. As punishment for Adivasi resistance to British rule, the Criminal Tribes Act was passed by the British Declaration, the Adivasi to be criminals. Adivasi uprisings in the Jharkhand belt were suppressed by deployment of troops across the region. Birsa Munda was one of the most prominent figures who led tribal uprising against the British. Unfortunately, even today, many Adivasis still live in extreme poverty. The rapid rate of urbanization and industrialization have led to the loss of habitat for many adivasis. Many forests have been cut down to build industries and cities. Since they have lost their homes and their primitive sources of livelihood, Adivasis have been forced to lead an urbanized life. However, most of them find it difficult to adjust to the new setup. While some sections of the Adivasi communities have got assimilated into the mainstream of the society, many of them are still battling poverty and illiteracy. The constitution aimed at educating the tribal people to enable them to adjust to the mainstream life. Special provisions have been made for them in the constitution. Other backward classes, another marginalized community are the other backward classes. They are known OBCs. They are separate, they are different to the SC and STs. Those who are socially and educationally backward, as have been recognized by the central or the state governments, they have been given reservations in government institutions so that they become well equipped to lead a better life. So in this way, we can say the government has provided special rights, special provisions to the SCs and STs. Also, the people of the society, those who are considered as other backward classes, they also given the special treatment, special opportunity in the field of education, employment, services, and many of the government policies. In this way, we can say the SCs, STs, or other marginalized section of the society is given special attention by the government to improve their condition in the country as well as in the society. Now, rest we shall discuss in the next video in coming time. Till then, thank you, goodbye.